Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri from Canada. In this video, we are going to learn how we can control 360 servo or continuous servo motor with three push buttons. We will have one push button. When you press it, the motor will rotate in a counterclockwise. The other push button will make it rotate in clockwise, and the third push button will stop the motor. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I have many video tutorials explaining regular servo motor that rotates from 0 to 180 degrees. When you modify a servo motor that has feedback which stops it at 0 or 180 degrees, it becomes continuous servo motor because there is no feedback inside the circuit. It's called 360 or continuous servo motor. You will not be able to control it in a certain angle, for example, if you want to rotate it 200 degrees and stop it, because it's not precisely controlled, unless you put some kind of encoder that detects the position of that. In this tutorial, we are simply learning how to send a command so it can change the direction or stop it, either in clockwise direction and then or change it in counterclockwise or stop it. Also, you will notice that when you press the stop button, the motor will stop, but slowly you will hear some clicks that it moves. The reason for that is the circuitry of the motor. The reason for this is the quality of the circuit in the device, because the resistors have maybe 5% or 10% tolerance, and the other components and the quality of the servo motor. You might be able to find a servo motor that when you press the stop button, it will fully stop. Keep that in mind, that in the example that I'm showing you, you will see that the servo motor will start moving a little, not too much. A while ago, I had another video explaining how to control this from the serial monitor command by sending L left or right or different commands to start and stop it and change the direction. The code for that will be available in the description, so you can watch that. I'm not going to spend time again explaining the same thing, but I have seen a lot of requests and interest in controlling servo motor with three push buttons, and you can replace these push buttons with a signal with whatever other means that you have. This looks like a regular servo, but this is actually continuous servo, or sometimes they call it 360 servo. What it means is that, as you saw with the servo which was going 180 degrees, going back and forth, this can run continuously either in clockwise direction or in counterclockwise direction. And controlling this, there was no code available to control it, so I have written this code, experimented, make sure it works, with some discrepancy that is. So when you press the clockwise or the right one, it will start rotating clockwise. When you press stop, it stops. When you press counterclockwise, the servo rotates in counterclockwise direction. You can directly press the clockwise so it can rotate to clockwise or counterclockwise, or stop it at any moment. Due to internal circuitry, so the stop command sometimes might not be perfect, and as a result you will see that this is slowly rotating. But it could be due to the quality of this specific servo, or maybe as the time goes by, the internal component gets warmer and this will behave like that. But you can adjust it and find the right value, so it can always be stopped. But it will not be fully stopped, so make sure to consider this. As you can see, it's now vibrating. It's just at the edge of rotating slowly. This servo looks exactly like a regular servo, but here they have some DS04 NFC. This is just a mark for a brand, but usually they look the same, all of them. It has internally, this has metal gear. So it comes with all of these hardware, different type of attachment, These four will go on the shaft, and depending on your application, whatever you want to control, these can be included, and also these screws and these bumper rubbers and all of this. And here for this servo motor, but still we have darker color for the ground. The middle color is for the positive, and the right lighter color on this one was orange, and this one, this is white. So ground have been connected to ground here. The middle one is red. I've put another red here connected to 5 volts. And then the left one is the signal input from Arduino, which have been connected to pin 9. And here for the push buttons, I use the same color that I've used in the wiring diagram. The black on this side have been connected to the ground of Arduino. And if I remove these wires, you will see that I've connected one wire here, the left side of this, which is connected to the left side of this, and from here I have another wire to the left of this, and all of them have been connected using this wire to the ground. And then the three wires that we have will be connected to the right of this button, the right of this button, and the right of this button. So three of them have been connected to pins 2, 3, and 4 in here. Let me explain the code. We start by including the servo.h, the header file, with this line, which I've explained it before. You have to include this, otherwise it will not work. And then using the same class, we create an instance of it. We call it my servo. And then we define pin 9 as a servo pin to connect the servo. And these three pins are used, pin 2, 3, and 4, will be used for clockwise, counterclockwise, and stop. And I call them stop pin, CW pin, CCW pin. These are constant and they will not change. This pin must be pulse width modulation pin, one of those pulse width modulation pins that has this tilde beside the name. But these are just digital pins. And after that, we are defining the values, the three values. This is an integer array of CS servo command. And I have three values with a comma separated. This is 106 is for counterclockwise, 52 is for stop, and 0 is for clockwise. I put them in order. Below this, we have string servo command text, and these are the text that will be displayed on the serial monitor. And then status text, this will remember the current status. And this is a text that will be displayed. Currently it's stopped and it is displayed. These three variables, clockwise button status, counterclockwise button status, and stop button status, will be used internally inside the loop, which we will see soon. Inside the setup, we use a serial monitor to initialize a serial monitor with 9600 baud, and then using pin mode, stop pin, clock, counterclockwise pin, and clockwise pin, we set them as input with a pull-up, so we can use a push button without a resistor, which I've explained it in my previous lectures. After that, we attach the servo using my servo.attach servo pin. This will be pin 9 in our case, to the servo. And then my servo.write is the command that sends command to the servo to either stop or move it. And CS1 is the stop command, CS servo command. If you pay attention here, this is a clockwise and this is a stop. We want at the beginning the servo to be stopped, so we send this command to stop the command, the servo, and also we send the text number 1 to show stop on the screen. Text 0, text 1, text 2. So this will send that text to us. After that, inside the loop, we read the three push button pins, CCW pin using digital read
And also the same thing for stop pin and CW pin, and we read the status of the pin, which is either high or low. And high will be 1, low will be 0. The result will be stored in this variable, which we defined above. And for the stop pin also will be stored in the stop button status and clockwise button status respectively. Then we check if counterclockwise button status is equal low, which means if it has been pushed, then we send this command, servo command 0. And this is a function which I'm going to explain next. It's in the lines below. And then else if stop button status, if that is equal low, which means if the stop button have been pushed, then we send command number 1, and which will send the value of number 1 from the array above. And then if it is clockwise button status low, then we send number 2. And then we print this text continuously to show the current status using this number. This number will pick up the value from the array, the appropriate text that I just mentioned, this text, stop. At the moment it is stopped because status is 1, and if you send 1 to this array, let me delete it so you can understand. If I put here 1, CS text 0, 1, 1 means stop, CS text, so it will print this text for us. And then we wait for 50 milliseconds and the loop continues like that. Now let's check this servo command. Servo command is a function that I've written below. When we pass that 0, 1 and 2, it will come here and becomes n integer, a variable, and then we immediately in this line we set the status text, either whatever it is, it will be 0, 1 and 2, and the text will be picked up as clockwise, counterclockwise or stop for our to be displayed. And then we use the same n to pick up the command, the number, and send the servo to that direction. Then we print this text. Also we print the text telling us the direction at the moment that is the button is pushed, and also we will display the value that is sent to the servo, and this is open parenthesis and closing parenthesis to display the value.
I've spent quite some time working on the code, testing it, experimenting, make sure it works, recording and uploading so you can easily use it. The least that you can do for me is to hit the subscribe button and leave the notification on. Thank you.
And now here is a demonstration. I'm opening the serial monitor here. So it shows stop. Remember, this stop will change by the time, because as the components get warmer, this will react differently. I believe this is due to the quality of the servo, or maybe generally all the servos will behave like that. You might experience difference when you connect the same code to your servo motor. And here are the 3 push buttons. I will just press clockwise. So this is rotating clockwise. I can press this without stopping as well. Immediately now it shows clock counterclockwise, but if I hold it, you will see also the value. Here it shows I'm sending now 106. That's angle that you send to the servo. And if I press stop, as it is a stop, now you see it is rotating a little. I will fix that as well. I'm going to show you how to fix it, but let's say to the right. So to make it rotate to the right, in this servo I'm sending 0. If I press it, you will see that inside the parenthesis that 0 is referring to the command that is sent. And stop, now you can see it is rotating a little to the left, and then it's going faster. So the amount of angle that you send will make this rotate slower or faster. Now let's fix this and see how we can fully stop it. Now the value that I have here is 58, and that is causing it to rotate that way. So let's reduce it, make it 50, and upload. It's fully, a little vibration is to the right, so which means from 58 I should have done it like 52 maybe. Now let's see. Uploaded. So it's vibrating but not going left or right. Moving. Stop. And left. So you can play with these numbers to increase or decrease it. Let's say for the left, if I make this 80, now uploading the code, so let's go to the right, that's the maximum speed, stop. Now this is moving a little slower with comparing to previous value, which I had 106. If I upload 106, you will see that this was slower with comparing to the now 106. It is faster. 0 to the right, 0, and 106. And this is a great project for many applications. I hope you enjoy using this.
I would like to sincerely thank the following people who have supported me via Patreon. Thank you for watching. This was how to control the 360 servo motor with push button on Arduino. If you learned something and found it useful, please thumb up. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below the video. I try to answer and reply. If you have not subscribed so far, you may subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos. Whether if you're studying mechatronic, electrical engineering, hobbyist, researcher, or high school student, I have an Arduino course that will teach you from ground up Arduino. My Arduino course at Udemy is arranged such that all the material are structured from absolute beginner to advanced, including all the library, codes, schematic diagram, and explanation step by step for all the projects are available to you. In no time, the knowledge that you gain from my course in Arduino, you will be able to implement it and build cool robotic or mechatronic projects that is beneficial for you and people around you. The link for my course on Udemy is below the video in the description. You can visit it now.